Welcome back to the channel. I know I said I'm going home on Friday, but it's now Wednesday and I changed my mind and I want to go home a little bit sooner. So what we have is my buddy Kyle's 40-foot trailer along with Thomas's crew cab back on the trailer, and we are going back to Indiana with it. And then we have some work to do back at the shop. I want to get the little baby truck done, so I left a little bit earlier, and I have been thinking, should I attempt to get it done for LST? All I got left is gotta get the head put on the motor, get the body painted, and throw it all together, which when all the parts are back, I'll be able to throw that truck together in the matter of 2 days. I have wheels and tires for it, temporary ones, of course. I want to get 30s and 42s for it. That's the end goal with it. Maybe 44s, depending on how it sits, because Thomas's truck sits very well on 42s, and right about how it's sitting now on the trailer is just how my little baby truck sits, but it doesn't have the adjustability like Thomas's truck. That is on 12-inch travel carbon shocks, which allows it to go up and down, because it is on an air ride, but it also has a coilover style mounting, which means you could put a coilover onto Thomas's truck if you really wanted to, but what's the fun in that? That'll be like my little baby truck, and that's no fun. We're gonna get some gas really quick, and then we are headed back on the highway through Georgia, through Tennessee, through Kentucky, and our final destination will be in Indiana back here at my shop in about 16 hours. One thing I can't get enough of is how this Cummins sounds with the trailer hooked up to it. Just the exhaust brake is quite insane when it downshifts. It literally sounds like we're driving a jet. I mean, we kind of are inside this 1500 horsepower fourth gen Cummins that is bone stock with just a tune and delete. So what do you guys think it's gonna cost me? I would say 160. What is the fuel prices here? 418 a gallon. Damn, that's honestly the cheapest I've seen it. I know coming down here, I spent about $600 driving just the truck itself here, but now we have a very large monster truck that is going back with us. Fuel prices are a lot cheaper where I'm at, so that's definitely a plus, but now to find, where we're gonna get fuel. That was a $105 fill up at $4.18 a gallon. And the last stop, it was 160, I just checked. So we just saved $60 and we put the same amount of fuel in it. So right now I won't complain. I think I filled up last, it was like 520 a gallon. That was kind of insane. But the Mega Cab now has a full tank of gas. We're back on the road to, I would say we'll make it to like Macon, Georgia, fill up again, and we'll make it up into Nashville, fill up again, and then I would say Louisville, Kentucky. We'll fill up there, and then that should get us pretty close to home. We'll probably have to fill up like an hour outside of the house, but let's get back on the road, and monster trucks are definitely for the win. The truck has been driving a lot better since we removed the 2-inch spacers off of it for the drive home, because I don't want to lose a wheel with all that excitement on the back. You guys may ask yourself, why do you travel so much? Reason being is I love doing this stuff, and how can you not love this wonderful sunset? The Mega Cab is definitely pulling like a champ. Gooseneck with 15,000 pound axles. This thing is a whole different animal than like a tri-axle or a single wheel trailer. My last buggy hauler was a tri-axle with just single wheels on it. My current gooseneck is a tandem dual just like this, and it does not have the max ramps on it, but we are in Live Oak, Florida at a rest stop, and I had to get out, had to use the bathroom obviously, because I drink Red Bull, a Mountain Dew, and water like no tomorrow. So we got out, checked all the straps, they're still doing good. What about those 30s? Jesus, it's bigger than, it's literally about bigger than me almost. This is how I travel. I'm usually by myself going to shows unless Gabe's with me. Right now we are getting back on the road, and let's see how this trip goes. And I will have this thing uploaded as soon as I get back to Indiana, because you guys want to keep seeing this content for 3 days. I guess I just got to hold the phone in my hand 24/7. I actually went out and bought like a little holder for it. I usually hold it with my hand, but now it has like a handheld thing, which allows me to turn the camera a lot better. I'm still learning how to twist this thing I'm holding. Yeah, a little bit shaky, but we'll get used to it. I mean, we can set it up now very easily. Cut. Holy shit. And it's literally 23 hours later, we made it back to my shop here in Indiana. And there are U-Haul trucks everywhere. The parking lot's actually halfway clean. Jesus. I haven't been on Indiana ground in literally forever. And I will say, I don't miss this weather. It's freezing. And I have a call coming in. Jesus, that thing rips. It has been so long since I have stepped foot into my building. And oh my God, it's actually warm inside here. I know I turned it down before I left. Let's see what our heat's at. The dually. We haven't seen the dually in so long. And the heat is at 60 degrees, yep. Brandon's home, so that means we'll set it at 72. We've got all the lights back on here inside the shop. Oh my God, like I can actually function. My little baby truck. I haven't seen. Am I dreaming? Am I really back home after being gone for how long? I literally don't know what's more insane. Having one of T-King's builds here, because Thomas has never had one of his builds here besides the green truck, and that was a while back. Having his big truck here with my big truck and with my little baby truck is kind of insane. Like, we've always talked about getting his truck up here, and now that it's here, I mean, it is pretty shitty outside, but we're gonna get this thing on the ground. I actually got the new hubs here somewhere for it. Let's see where those are at. And then we'll throw the new hubs on it. We'll go grab some axle shaft, U-joints, and get this front axle together, because I know I have been slacking a lot on it, but now that there's a second gen here that's literally done, that's not mine, mine needs to be done. So what are we doing here today? I slept in about 36 hours. I'm wide awake, and we're gonna unload the crew cab, park it up front here, get the dually outside to the parking spot, little baby truck on the lift, back the crew cab in, and maybe sell these Archons as well, because I don't want these. So if you guys need any 24x14, 8x170 Archons, per everyone's request, the little baby truck needs done, obviously, like we already talked about. So I just got the front gears back in it, setting that up right now. Gotta get the yoke to slide onto it because there's powder coat into this yoke. Get that to slide onto it. Then we can get the U-joints put into the axle shaft, slide those in, put our new hubs on, because we went out and we bought brand new hubs for this truck. I think they're Master Pros. So we got two brand new hubs right here for it. These definitely are not cheap, but there's two of them here. And the good thing is we're not using these old rusty ones that you guys have seen on here, because I just put these on so I can roll it around. But now we'll be able to get everything bolted on now, get our rotors onto the axle. Yes, figure out these, because these are definitely gonna be the project. I don't foresee them going back together very easily. I do know this one is pushed back in to an extent. I might be going to buy new calipers and just painting them black, because these are all powder coated. Everything's powder coated. But they kind of got a little bit of powder coat inside this one right there. We'll have to die grind out all the powder coat inside there. Or we'll probably just take these and drop them off at the U-joint place in the morning. That'll be the easiest. That way they can get mounted up and everything get done. We got to get a diff cover, seal, gasket for the rear. Get that on, get that filled up with fluid. That one's all set up. All we have left to do is pull the wheels off and then get the seals for the axle shafts and then throw the calipers onto the mounts. As you guys can see, everything's already done on it. One thing that's involved after traveling for 22 days, and yes, I washed the truck a lot, but now it's filthy because I drove it back to Indiana. So we're gonna see if this thing fits into the Family Express car wash this morning on 14 wides. So we are gonna attempt that right now. And now, just like that, we should be pulling out of this car wash squeaky clean, and hopefully. Oh yeah, I mean, it's better than it was. Definitely a lot better than it was. Let's hop out and see. I would say that was worth $14. Maybe I'll switch from Birdie's car wash to Family Express's $14 washes, because this one cleans it a lot better. Yeah, she's clean. She's a lot cleaner now. Alrighty, time to go to the shop. We got work to do. Oh, one sip of the Big Kahuna and we're off. We have arrived at the shop, and I got the axle shaft seals on here. Got to torque those down to spec yet still. I ordered up the gasket for the diff cover, like I said. Got to tighten up this one still. How about the new axle shaft seal? Everything is brand new.
Which is literally insane because I've never done a truck like this to this extent, to where everything on it's new. It's got all new hubs, all new seals. All the bolts are like perfect. But one thing we do have to do is pull the batteries out of Thomas's crew cab, because I guarantee you this thing is stone dead right now and it's not gonna start. I'm not even gonna attempt to start it because I already know that it's dead. So I'm gonna pull the batteries out of this and go grab him some new batteries, or take these ones down to O'Reilly's and have them tested, because I bought these batteries like 3 years ago when Thomas decided to give me a call and he's like, hey, I found a crew cab I wanna buy. I was like, yeah, where's it at? He's like, oh, it's not far from you. So I grabbed the trailer, I grabbed the gray dually, and I started my adventure that way into Illinois. Yeah, I ended up in Nebraska in 0 degree weather in a freaking blizzard. There was like 3 feet of snow on the ground, I felt. And that's where I first picked up this truck. It was red. It obviously did not look like this. And I don't even think it ran at the time. So I picked it up. I froze my ass off. I think the heater core went out of my truck. And something else happened. I forgot. Oh, the TKs exploded in the middle of a snowstorm. And I somehow mangled it back together in Home Depot parking lot at 6 a.m. I made it back to Indiana. And then he flew in, got it running. And then I forgot what else he did. He might have bought another truck and towed it back home to Fort Myers. Here we are today. It's back in Indiana. But it doesn't look how it looked the last time it was here, which is kind of insane, because if you guys followed the channel way back when, you guys will remember this truck. It was red, had a sport front end on it already. It was at stock height, and now it's blue, still has a sport front end, and it's still at stock height. So not much has changed on it since last time it was here. I do know that it's twin turbo now, which is pretty insane. He hasn't gotten around to getting all the powder coat stuff done down here, but he did paint the firewall, which looks very, very, very good. So once he gets all of his stuff for under the hood, gets everything powder coated, this thing should make about 2,500 horsepower, and it should blow those 42-inch Venom tires off, and it should definitely spin the 30s very, very fast. This thing definitely seen the elements on the way home. Luckily, there was no salt or snow that I passed through, but it definitely needs a detail now. And I don't think this truck has ever been dirty. And then it gets in my hands on the way back to Indiana. And unfortunately, the weather did make it dirty. It's definitely dusty, I will say that. And it needs some love down here. It's not terrible though, but it is dirty. And Thomas always keeps his truck like spick and span. So I'm gonna have a detailer come by, have him detail the crew cab. Probably have the mega cab detailed, because that thing is dirty. I mean, I did just wash it, but from the time I drove from the car wash around town for like an hour, it's dirty again. And that is why the crew cab is inside and my dually is outside, because that dually has sat out there for I don't know how long, so it's not gonna hurt my feelings sitting out there a little bit longer. And this outweighs that right now. But once that's done, this is obviously done, this will be done, that might be gone, or I don't know what's gonna happen with the mega cab. That's not on my checklist anymore that we're home from Florida. But this one and that one outside are on my list. So once everything's done, what do you guys think is gonna happen? I know 1, 2, 3 of my trucks aren't gonna fit in my shop. And when Thomas's truck is with us, that's not gonna fit as well. So that does mean we are moving out of the shop and we're gonna venture off into new opportunities, like I have said in my other videos. And I cannot wait for what's next. I have grown out of this shop here. I'm very thankful and grateful for everything I have accomplished here inside the shop and building a lot of trucks in here. We definitely need to expand the shop side of it and the storage side of it, so nothing has to sit outside. And my goal is to be able to pull my mega cab with the trailer loaded down into my shop eventually. I don't know if that's gonna happen this next round with the shop, but it's all about improving every day and growing yourself, your business, and doing what makes you happy. Once the sign comes down outside and on the building and inside of here, it's definitely gonna bring tears, but I think it's gonna be tears of joy this time. And I cannot wait to see what's next and what opportunities are gonna open up when we are into a bigger space. I don't know if I'm gonna go to another storefront. I might go to property, which allows me to have fun and do more things for YouTube, but definitely need a spot where I can fit everything. Because when I first moved in here, All I had was the lime green Duramax, and then I sold that. I bought what was the blue truck. So I only had one truck at the time. I didn't have this. I had this truck, but it wasn't really a truck. That thing didn't really come about until the blue truck was painted and I bought the body and all the parts for it. And then now I've just outgrown so much in this shop to where there's stuff everywhere. The workbench is covered. Both bays are full. There's not really much space here anymore for me versus when I moved in here, because I now have a lot of stuff acquired, and I bet when I get into a bigger building, more stuff's definitely gonna, it's just how it goes. The back room's filled, the carport's filled, there's a lot of stuff everywhere, but we're gonna get these batteries out, get this thing running, and start it up again because it is drained. And I know if it sits outside, it's definitely not going to start because it's cold out there. And that's gonna end today's video though. That was kind of like a vlog that we just filmed coming home from Florida. And let me know what you guys think about this style of a video. I know that you guys love seeing like all of this stuff being built, which we'll still do. Don't worry, I'm not just gonna build them and then vlog it. That's no fun. We'll still film the whole process, whether it's welding, assembling, tearing them down. We'll get all of that covered. And definitely in the new building, we'll have more opportunities for more cameras, more money to be made. And the videos are just gonna keep on getting better from here on out. So drop a comment, let me know what you guys think, and I will see you guys in the next video for sure, here in a couple days. I have to get this done. The axle is just about done up front. I'm waiting on the seals that go in right here. And that will wrap up the axles on this, but thanks for watching. Drop the comment, like, subscribe, and I will see you guys in a couple days.